Good morning. I don't think that Duncan has said anything to you guys this morning yet, so good morning. I am actually in downtown Windermere, about to go get my nails done, and today is going to be sort of one of those days where we're not really sure what's gonna happen. So I keep looking to the side of, like, I'm parked on the side of the road. It's like parallel parking, and then there's only one lane of road, so I feel like when a car drives by, it's like super duper close, even though I'm far within the line. But it's still, you can see him coming, and it seems really close. Anyway, going to get my nails done. We have fast passes for the new Rivers of Light show. We are one. I'm not sure if Duncan's gonna make it home in time to go, but I wanted to have the fast passes just in case. I'm recording episode 2 of the main entrance cast podcast with my friend Nick, and then of course my weekly plan all my social media posts kind of stuff. So I also have a like to-do list that's been hanging out forever. I doubt I'm gonna get to it today, but we're sure gonna give it an effort. But for now, I'm gonna go get my nails done. All right, I'm done with my nail appointment. You guys ready for the big reveal? So I'm gonna show them to you. I don't normally do stuff like this to my nails, only special occasions. And we will be in Disneyland. Well, we'll be traveling to Disneyland a week from tomorrow, so I had to do something fun. So here we go. I know that's kind of hard to see. It's kind of blurry. All right, so I'm gonna flip the camera around and Duncan can edit this out. So we've got polka dots. Little Mickey's, Minnie, Mickey. My car is really dusty right there. Same thing on the other hand. And then Minnie is here. She did such a good job. So if you're local to Windermere-ish and you are looking for a nail tech, let me know. She's the best. And maybe I'll put her Instagram, or have Duncan put her Instagram on the screen now. Hey guys, we are coming to you from Animal Kingdom. Well, the parking lot. We got fast passes to see the new Rivers of Light. We are one last minute. We didn't know if Duncan was gonna make it in time. Right now we're loading up our pockets so that we can get back to Asia to be able to scan our bands. We have 15 minutes until the end of our fast pass, so we are going to see you there.
We made it, but there may have been casualties.
First of all, second of all, I tore my calf. Both of them.
Over dramatic.
No, it's bad. Also, it's so hot.
It's so hot.
Namaste, and welcome to Rivers of Light. Tonight, we gather together at the water's edge as one community in celebration of life.
Stepping to the sun.
Yeah.
pulled over to the side. We have not talked about it to ourselves yet. We saved it specifically for you guys.
Ooh, hot takes.
Yeah. Oh. So we're standing outside of the Yak and Yeti quick service. But the park is closed. It's been closed for like 20 minutes. So all that there is in here are people walking out from
watching the show.
And then, yeah, watching Rivers of Light. So this is our take on Rivers of Light. We are one. Immediate thoughts?
It was entertaining.
Yeah. Yeah, it was. So some backgrounds. We did not like the original Rivers of Light. We really, really wanted to like the Rivers of Light. We did not. I actually preferred the Thrown Together because Rivers of Light couldn't get open in time, alive with the magic of the Jungle Book or whatever that was. Alive with magic.
Yeah.
And I liked that more than I liked original Rivers of Light. So there were pieces of Rivers of Light that were still in there, like some of the music, all the barges.
The barges.
The lotuses, and some of the music is the same as well. But what I liked is that they put Disney into it. So it starts with like the Circle of Life, ends with the Circle of Life, which is really all it was missing for me. Like, here's my downfall though. The water screens still don't work.
The ones on the side worked actually really well.
Yeah.
The one in the middle, the big one, like because they're projecting on the middle of where the water is like crossing, doesn't come out clean.
It still doesn't work.
But they worked on that because that one, those barges were walking around with a screen on it.
Yeah.
To show you what the thing was showing. So
yeah,
like,
I thought that was a nice thing because I started watching that instead when it was.
Yeah.
But you would only be able to see that if you were in certain seating areas, and this was not a very full show.
Yeah. I did like at the end with the juxtaposition of like the real animal and the cartoon
that
animal.
That was cool.
That was a really good. Yeah. That was a really good touch.
You know, I still feel like this could use a better story. Like, sometimes you don't need a story, I feel. Like, you know, I'm not looking for Fantasmic, but, like, this still, like, I liked, maybe I missed it because there was the child in front of us, like, fell off the bench during the beginning narration. So I was distracted. So, but I mean, halfway through it started to, like, tie it together.
Yeah.
You know, We Are One. But you know what? I guess I was thinking We Are One since they had it specifically in the tagline, because that's not a new song that they had in there.
Right.
I was thinking they were going to use We Are One from Lion King 2. So I kept waiting for that, and I was like, oh, they don't mean that. But shout out to every animal Disney movie that there is, like Lion King, Brother Bear, Fox and the Hound.
And I'm going to guess that 90% of the live-action animals are from the Disney Nature stuff.
They are, for sure. I saw a lot from Chimpanzee.
But yeah, there was a lot of great stuff in there.
Yeah.
I would say that this is probably closer to what it was originally supposed to be, because it made sense to, yeah, like, for why they would build, like, a stadium for it and stuff. But I was highly entertained.
Yeah.
I might actually be willing to go see that again.
Yeah, I know, me too. I feel like it's still not, like, a must-do for me, but if I was here at night and I wasn't rushing
and I wasn't,
home,
like, trying to get out of here.
Yeah, I would stay for it. I felt like it. Plus, like,
that is not how we felt about the last one.
I love The Lion King, so anything that's going to give The Lion King some love. By the way, can we talk about Moana was in it? That was kind of weird.
Yeah, I mean, it was about the water and nature. That was when it was about nature. Because there was other water stuff on that, too.
Yeah. I mean, sure, the turtle. It was just weird.
But
like, baby Moana got more screen time than the turtle it was supposed to be about.
I mean, it was about the sea.
Kind of. Ooh, storm scene?
Yeah, that was really
cow.
Cool.
Worth it for just that.
Yeah, it was a good moment.
Yeah, I won't spoil what happens after the storm scene, but it is.
I mean, they might see it. So.
You might see it. Never mind. But if you don't see it, or didn't catch it, worth everything for that.
Yeah, there was some really good stuff. There were good moments.
Mm-hmm. Cool. We're gonna go get a snack.
Bye.
Hey, so we're back, and I was really thirsty after running through Animal Kingdom. So I wanted to get fountain soda. And long story short, there was a miscommunication and we were thinking different places. And why is everyone crawling all over?
None of this is for you dogs.
We tried to go to the Taco Bell over by Crossroads. That wasn't a thing. And I don't know what it is about Taco Bells around here, but they always have long lines and they never
are efficiently staffed.
Yeah, they're never efficient. So
I also am one of those people that can't stand McDonald's soda. I don't know what it is. Some people love McDonald's soda. I can't stand it. It's too sweet. So we found a Wendy's that had no line, so I could get my fountain soda and dunking out of Frosty. But FYI, the Wendy's in Windermere has Coke Freestyle. So you know that's important to me. Now I know. What do you think is happening? This is a soda. She's not interested now. But we didn't watch The Bachelorette this week yet, last week, depending on what you consider Sunday. So we're going to watch last Monday's episode so that we can watch the new one tomorrow.
Someone's finally ready with her picks.
I felt like there were a lot of whiny guys on tonight.
So pick five of the not whiny guys. It's not that hard.
I have a really hard time in the beginning of the seasons. Like,
I'm not trying to pick a winner. No, I'm just trying to pick.
I know, but like, I get them all confused because like, I feel like the producers are starting to do a really good job of like finding the person's type.
Oh, yeah.
And there's always one that looks like another, and it's confusing to me.
Anyways, I, like, memorized my list, so we need to give the list, or I'm going to forget.
Okay.
Not lying. Okay. Number one.
Luke.
Which one?
Both.
You have both on there?
Mm-hmm.
Cheater. You didn't even remember there were two.
Yeah, I do.
I have Luke P as well. And I have Pilot Peter. You have Pilot Peter?
No.
Who else do you have?
Mike.
Mike Johnson? Yes.
The portfolio guy?
Yeah.
I thought that we were down to one Mike.
Yeah, but he introduced himself by full name. I think we only had one Mike.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
But yes, I also had him.
Tyler?
I did not pick a Tyler. I have Connor S.
I picked Cam, even though I personally can't stand him.
He was creepy.
Yeah. She gave the girl chicken nuggets. He's moving on.
I think my fifth one was Tyler. I don't remember now.
I have my list memorized.
Yeah, I told you I was going to forget if we kept chit-chatting. That's five. Yep. We're the same on most of them. Let's be real. This will either be great or tragic for both of us. Here we go. So she was passed out during the whole Bachelor viewing. I had to carry her upstairs. She instantly curled up to go back to sleep. She knew I was talking about her. Gadget. Gadget. Don't look the bed on camera, please. Yeah. Nah.
So, what did you think of the episode?
It was very drama filled for like the second
episode. That's what I felt too.
But they're working the characters, right? To set up some people to have some pretty epic falls. I also feel like this is the first time I felt like Hannah wasn't ready for what this is.
Yeah, the crying at the beginning of the toast.
That was weird. Like, I more meant the like fact that she's stuck in infatuation mode with Luke P.
Yeah.
And like can't get over it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if you think at the end you're going to get engaged, you should be, like, cruising past that thing, like, way before where she's at.
Yeah. Plus, I feel like he's going to lose it.
I mean, the previews pretty much showed he was about
to, like... Well, I mean, I don't believe the previews, but I think he'll actually, like, snap. but
yeah, she has two guys that are very much like control freaks. Mm-hmm.
But for the record, I think I chose Cam. I don't think he should get a rose. He did get a rose. By the way, we were both 5 for 5.
5 for 5.
But Cam is definitely getting the villain edit.
Yeah.
But he's also doing some weird stuff.
He's getting the early villain edit, which means, like, he's going to get bounced so fast. He's yeah. probably going to be gone next week.
But, like, seriously, if someone would give me chicken nuggets on a platter, you'd get a rose for me, too. Just saying. And those were McDonald's nuggets, though. That was kind of weird. I'm just saying.
But you can't spit in the face of the process and expect to stay on very long. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But anyway. So tomorrow is Memorial Day. I am off.
I am not.
Yep. So I don't really know what tomorrow is going to bring. Probably laundry, doing stuff I didn't do today, and getting ourselves in a good spot for vacation. So, we'll see though. You never know what happens when Disney's in your backyard.
Truths. Mm-hmm. Truth facts.
So, see you tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
Hey, Alex, thanks for coming to the show!
Ask for what?
I've been saying.
And for what?